You know, it's not uncommon to meet someone from a certain generation who might not understand or even be a little frustrated with someone from a different generation. There might be an opportunity for miscommunication, misunderstanding, or just not connecting. Why is that? What can be done about that? Well, in Titus chapter 2, listen to what Paul writes to Titus, a younger pastor, about how to navigate those kind of generational dynamics. Verse 1, he says, "As for you, Titus, promote the kind of living that reflects wholesome teaching. Teach the older men to exercise self-control, to be worthy of respect, and to live wisely. They must have sound faith and be filled with love and patience. Similarly, teach the older women to live in a way that honors God. They must not slander others or be heavy drinkers. Instead, they should teach others what is good. These older women must train the younger women to love their husbands and their children, to live wisely and be pure, to work in their homes and to do good and to be submissive to their husbands. Then they will not bring shame on the word of God." Listen, he goes on in verse 6 and says, "In the same way, encourage the young men to live wisely, and you yourself must be an example to them by doing good works of every kind. Let everything you do reflect the integrity and the seriousness of your teaching." You see, the important lesson that we learned from Titus 2 this morning is oh so simple. That which is learned is not just taught, but caught. You see, it's the lifestyle and the lessons that must go together. For there to be a generational connection, it's the life well lived and the lesson well communicated that's the ingredients for a healthy generational conversation. See, I don't think we have to be concerned. What's God going to do with this next generation? Listen, God knows. And God is raising up leaders to reach their generation in a unique and fresh way. No matter what generation we find ourselves in today, let's live well and pass on the lessons that we've been entrusted with to those around us. Because truly, this is the way that we can learn the Word of God so that we can live the Word of God well in our generation and see it passed on to the next one.